From this lecture, we will talk about the practical transformer. For practical transformer, the permeability is finite. There are several types of losses in the practical transformer, and they are core loss, copper loss, eddy current loss, hysteresis loss, etc. And these losses are not negligible and they must be included in the calculation. And also, the leakage flux should be taken into the account in the case of practical transformers. There are some constructional changes that must be included. First constructional changes is that so winding resistance R1 and the leakage resistance X1 must be included in the primary winding, and winding resistance R2 and the leakage reactance X2 must be included in the secondary winding. Resistance for loss component in the core, which is RC, must be added with already existing magnetizing component, which is XM. In no load condition, transformers draws a very small current in order to supply the core loss and magnetizing current. That's why we will not consider resistance and reactance connected in the both of the windings. So the equivalent circuit looks like this. Here we assume that supply provided in the primary is V1, induced voltage in the primary is E1, induced voltage in the secondary is E2, and the voltage across the load in the secondary is V2. As there is no load and secondary is kept open, that's why current flowing in the secondary winding or I2 equal to 0, and voltage across the load of the secondary winding or V2 is also equal to 0. As the current in the secondary winding is I2 is 0, therefore magnetomotive force in the secondary winding is also 0. So no extra current will be flowing in the primary winding to neutralize the demagnetizing effect of the secondary current. So additional current I2 prime, which is KI2, is also equal to 0. So the primary winding will draw a very small current. Hence, the secondary winding is not causing any effect on the magnetic flux setup in the core or on the current drawn by the primary. So the primary winding will draw a very small current from the supply, which is I0, and it will flow through the shunt branch made of reactance and resistance. It is usually 2-5% of the rated value of the full load current. This current will be utilized to supply the iron loss, which includes eddy current and hysteresis loss in the core, and a very small amount of copper loss in the primary. Now, the current in the primary, or I1, is equal to I0 plus I2 prime, and as I2 prime is equal to 0, the current in the primary will be equal to I0. This current I0 is not purely inductive, as it flows through the shunt branch, which is consist of resistive and inductive components. That's why it will not lag the alternating supply voltage V1 by an angle of 90 degree. As it is an RL branch, the primary current I0 will lag the supply voltage V1 by an angle of phi naught. This phi naught is called the hysteresis angle of advance, and it will be less than 90 degree. The current I0 has two components, so I0 is equal to IW plus IM. The component which is in phase with the alternating voltage V1, it is denoted by IW, and this is called the active or working component. It supplies the iron losses, which includes hysteresis and eddy current losses, and a small primary copper loss. It flows through the exciting resistance R0, and it is in phase with the supply voltage V1. It is denoted by IW is equal to I0 cos phi naught. The component which is lagging behind the alternating supply voltage V1 is called IM. It lags behind the supply voltage V1 by an angle of 90 degree. It is known as magnetizing component. It produces mutual flux in the core. This current is not responsible for the loss. It is wattless, and it flows through the exciting reactance X0. And IM is equal to I0 sine phi naught. So finally, the phasor representation of no load current, or I0, is equal to IW plus IM, and the magnitude of no load current I0 is equal to root over IW square plus IM square. We can calculate the no load power. In order to calculate the no load power, we require no load power factor, which is cos phi naught, which can be determined from IW by I0, which is I0 cos phi naught divided by I0. So the magnitude of no load power, or P0, is equal to V1 I1 cos phi naught, or V1 I0 cos phi naught. Now the exciting resistance R0, it carries the power loss component of the no load current, and the magnitude of this exciting resistance R0 is equal to V1 by IW. And exciting reactance X0, it carries the wattless component of the no load current. The magnitude of this X0 is V1 by IM. Copper loss in the case of no load condition in a transformer is I0 square R. It is very small and can be neglected. Let's take a look at the phasor diagram for the no load condition of the practical transformer. At first, you will take the main flux phi m as reference. Now, both the EMF E1 and E2 are in phase with each other, and they both lag the main reference flux phi m by an angle of 90 degree. And both of the EMF U1 and E2 are antiphase with the supplying alternating voltage V1. So both of the EMF are 180 degrees out of phase with the supplying alternating voltage V1. And E1 is also known as self-induced EMF, which is equal to minus V1. And E2 is called the mutually induced EMF, which is equal to minus KV1. At no load, there is no current in the secondary, so we can write V2 is equal to 0. And on the primary side, drop through the resistance and drop through the reactance is very small. So U1 is equal to V1 and the no load current I0 is also very small. The voltage across the shunt branch is equal to U1 and the current flowing through the shunt branch is equal to I0. The shunt branch is consist of reactance and inductance. So this will make an RL circuit. An RL circuit is lagging in nature. So the current I0 will also be lagging the alternating supply voltage V1 by an angle of I0. Let's talk about this no load current I0. This no load current I0 has two components, IW and IM. And magnitude of this no load current I0 will be root over IW square plus IM square. Magnetizing current IM is a purely inductive current. In other words, it will lag the alternating supply voltage V1 by an angle of 90 degree. And it will be in phase with the reference flux phi m. And it is very small in magnitude. So Im can be denoted as Im is equal to I0 sine phi naught. Loss component of the no load current IW, which is the purely resistive current. In other words, it will be in phase with the alternating supply voltage V1. And it is in phase quadrature with the reference flux phi m. And it is also very small in magnitude. IW can be denoted as I0 cos phi naught. And the vector sum of these two current components is I0. Now, primary current I1 is equal to I0. So, as the shunt is not purely inductive in nature, this current I0 will lag the supply voltage V1 by an angle less than 90 degree, or it will lag the supply voltage V1 by an angle equal to phi naught. As there is no load connected in the secondary winding, the current flowing through the secondary winding or I2 will also be equal to 0. This concludes our discussion for this lecture. In the event that you have any question regarding this presentation, feel free to post them in the comment section and don't forget to hit the subscribe button. See you in the next one.